spirit of the living God. Fall afresh upon me. Spirit of the living God. Fall afresh upon these thy people. Spirit of the living God. Fall especially upon Loretta Jack C. Washington, the leadership of this Canaan United Methodist Church. Come, Holy Spirit, sweet heaven above. Come, Holy Spirit from heaven above. Come, Holy Spirit, with all of dying, quickening power. For your humble servant, Ronald, needs you now, this very hour. Now, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my mouth be acceptable in thy sight. For indeed you are my rock, my strength, and my redeemer. Church, say amen. Have your Bible. I want to go back to the King James Version. I know it was read earlier for your hearing. But if you be patient with me for just a little while, I'd like for you to hear from the King James Version. Amen.
Amen.
That same gospel recorded by Luke, the 16th chapter, beginning at verse 19. There was a certain man, a certain rich man, who was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. But there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, full of souls, who was laid at his gate, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. So it was that the beggar died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And being in torment in hell, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. Then he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus that he may dip his finger, just the tip of his finger, in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, son, remember that in your lifetime you received your good things, and likewise Lazarus' evil things. He said, but now he is comforted, and you are tormented. And besides all of this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, so that those who want to pass from here to you cannot, nor can those from there pass to us. Then the rich man said this, I beg you, therefore, Father Abraham, that you would send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, that he may testify to them, unless they also come to this place of torment. Abraham said to him, there they have Moses and the prophets. He said, let them hear them. And he said, no, Father Abraham, but if one goes to them from the dead, he will repent. But he said to him, if they do not hear Moses and the prophet, neither will they be persuaded through one who have risen from the dead. Tonight, if I could put a topic on this passage of scripture, I share with you tonight, don't let it be said too late. Well, if somebody don't like that, let me give you another topic, just in case you don't like that. Tell your neighbor, the one right next to you, I don't care, to the left, I tell them,
death
is not the end.
It's not the end.
Glory to God. To the great architect of the universe, and to the angel of this Canaan and the church in Reverend Jack Washington, its leaders and committee members, and you, all of you in your respective places, I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Bring you greeting from the Beaver Dam Baptist Church there in Aiken, South Carolina, and the Young Rosemary Baptist Church in Williston, South Carolina, under the leadership of the pastor, Finnessy Young. I served there as one of his associates. All right. Glory to God. Yes. Don't let it be said too late. I need the old, I need the every hour, I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior, I come to thee. In the 16th chapter,
another name?
No name.
But the Bible declared that he was dressed in purple. How do you know purple is royalty?
Yes, sir.
And that he was dressed in fine linen.
Yes, that's what the text says.
Reverend Jack, but let me show this brother. You know, them fellas wearing them alligator shoes. You see that, don't you? Yeah. We making the finest thing of there is.
Go ahead.
I know you drive your Lexus and your Mercedes Benz, and that's all right. Let me help you there. And ain't nothing wrong.
All right.
And the Bible declared that he fed sumptuously every day. What that means is that he had the best of food.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And now the second character.
Yes.
He said that there was a certain babe.
Yes.
But watch what God does now. He gave him a name, Lazarus.
Yes.
Now let me help somebody here. Somebody gonna get it all mixed up. It's ain't Lazarus that was the brother of Mary. There's more than one character in the Bible that has the same name.
Right.
If y'all don't believe it, let me prove it to you. I'm wrong, man.
Yeah.
How many of y'all know another Ronald?
Mm-hmm.
I know I heard a Ronald Reagan.
Right.
All of us being wrong, but we need to say wrong.
Right.
Am I right about it?
Right.
Yeah, so here he is, Lazarus down, sitting at the gate. And the Bible declared that he was full of souls waiting. To fall from the rich man's table.
It's a little something.
Yes, something. Didn't want much. And the Bible declared that he was full of sores.
Yes.
And I can imagine the pain that he may have been going through.
Yes.
Well, the Bible will tell me that while he was there waiting,
right now,
the rich man had no compassion.
That's right.
But to tell me that there are laws for dogs, and I thank God for dogs sometimes.
Talk about it.
Because I have one, and he's a mighty good friend of mine. And I can imagine now, I want y'all to know something about this dog before I go any further.
Go ahead.
This wasn't the dressed up poodle.
Mm.
I ain't a hot dog.
All right.
Let me help somebody. Y'all think you all dressed up. No. Sooner, Jack, you know, sooner one thing or the other, y'all know what that is. But here he is, Lazarus sitting there at the rich man, hoping that just a crumb would fall from the table. And I can imagine that the dog beating to the crumb. I can imagine the dog every time Lazarus stuck his hand out. Soul for him, talking, maybe kind of helping the pain that he's going through.
Right.
Glory to God.
Yes.
And the dog showed more compassion than the rich man. Don't y'all live like that. You hear what I said?
Right.
Because the equalizer between Lazarus and the rich man is just this. The Bible tell me that so it was that the baby died 23rd verse, I believe it is, it tells me that a rich man being in torment in hell. The first thing he did, and I want you to hear me tonight, is that he lifted up his eyes.
Go ahead now.
Yes, sir.
And that's what I want you to do tonight. You ought to be able to lift up your eyes.
Amen.
Because I heard the song says that I lift up my eyes up unto the hills whence cometh my help. But I stopped by tonight to tell you on my way to heaven that I looked up unto the hills, but it wasn't the hills where I got my help.
Lord.
For the Bible declares my help. It's right there in that 24 verse. It said, well, he said, he cried, glory to God. Said to Father Abraham, could you have a little mercy on me? I want you to know tonight, in that 121st division of Psalms, said that I cried. And I want you to get this one for me. He prayed.
Yes, he did.
He prayed. All right. Because the Bible declared that he begged.
Yeah.
And when you beg, you're pleased.
Yeah.
He said, please let it go down.
Yes, sir.
But I heard Father Abraham said, no. Besides, there is a gulf that's been fixed by the Lord.
Yes.
I can't put it my way.
Yes, sir.
He said, you can't come to us, and we don't want to come to you. He said, now, how much did they got Moses? And they got the prophets. You know who they are, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, Jose, just the name of you. I'm just going to go on. I ain't got time tonight. He said, but you didn't listen to them. Somebody tell you tonight, Canaan, that you have Reverend Jack. Glory to God.
Go ahead now.
You have Reverend Ron. Right. You have Bishop Olson. If you don't listen to them, while the blood is running warm in your veins, I heard that it's too late. When death comes knocking on your door,
tonight.
Yes. All right.
Go to church.
Yes.
Stand.